I'll be honest, I like making Notion templates. It's one of my favorite things to do. I like making them, I like doing tutorials on them, I like showcasing how to use them. And the main reason I like doing it is because I have tutorials associated with my Notion templates very often. But when it comes to Notion templates in general, there's actually a lot of problems that come with it. First of all, unless you have something that really showcases how to use them, to the new user, they're not useful and they don't really teach them anything. You need to like take them through like a course on how to use the software in order for a lot of these to make sense. I have some really advanced templates I want to bring out, like a client management one that is going to be a little bit difficult due to the fact that it has these formulas in it. And when I try to explain one of the templates to somebody, I understood just how much my knowledge gap is from even those that watch my content. Like for me, I tried to make my Notion templates at riseproductive.com as simple as possible, like the simple habit tracker, workout calendar, a little bullet journal, some GTD stuff. And then the Evergreen Notion workspace, I plan on making a whole course that's free based on it. My workspace is just a bunch of simple ones I put together that I used to use. All of these are pretty simple as well. And then all of my templates, generally speaking, outside of maybe my second brain so far and my business CRM have been pretty simple. But there's a crazy world out there with all these Notion templates that exist. And for those of you that want to take your Notion workflow and get it customized, I do consulting. I have some clients and I'd love to work with you as well. So that's just an aside there. But I think it's important that you make your workspace your own based off inspiration you take from some of this kind of stuff. Because Thomas Frank's awesome. He has sold a lot of templates and has made great stuff. But if you don't make it your own, I don't feel like it's as good. I've never actually had a template personally that I have loved. I've loved making something that then I've turned into a template for people to buy eventually. But I've never had it be the other way around. So while I encourage all of you to try out my templates, I think ultimately tweaking them is going to be better. In my opinion, one of the main problems too is that it's not anything that's insanely good. I know I've had friends who also make Notion videos who have stopped making Notion videos due to part of the irritation that comes along with the fact that they don't know if they're getting ripped off from people because they see other people making videos on it later. And I've had some of my own skepticism around people as well. I'm not calling anyone out specifically. It's just, it's really difficult because obviously people can come to the same logical conclusion, but I've had inspiration from other templates. I've tried to give verbal, like, hey, like my personal finance tracker one I made last year, like that was totally Red Gregory. And that's why that one's free, of course, because it's like, I'm not going to rip somebody's template. The book library one that I recently made was from another Notion ambassador. They made an awesome book library template. That one's free because it's like, I didn't make that really. I just got inspiration and then made some tweaks to it. So when you do that, it's really important in my opinion to give credit where credit is due and understand that they made it for their own way their brain works. And Notion is one of those things that's so customizable that you really should tweak with somebody and talk with somebody who knows what they're talking about in Notion and figure out its capabilities and what you want out of its capabilities. I can make a whole system for you that is perfect in my head, but doesn't make any sense in yours. I oftentimes think that's why people don't bother with Notion is because they need templates and then they need to work with somebody, which I totally understand. But once I got the system down that I wanted, I have really not been annoyed by anything in my system for like months. Once I switched to the Evergreen Notion workspace I made, I'm pretty stoked with it. I like it. I tweak some things and sync headers and stuff, but nothing much. The honest to God only problem that I have with Notion at this point is the fact that I have to go back and forth between my calendar app and it. When it becomes a little bit more like a daily planner with like a sync database integration, I'm going to be sitting pretty and really can't complain. With their acquisition of Cron, I envision a world where a bunch of daily planner applications are going to have to compete with Notion's ability to have templates that look like daily planners. Because imagine a world where you can easily drag and drop Notion pages onto a sync database with a Google Calendar. It'll just be like a easy sync database style daily planner app. But also if they give us a week view, then it's game over for daily planner apps, in my opinion, because it's $4 a month versus like 10 to 15 across the board. And if we get quick capture too, it's going to be crazy. But the thing there is even then the templates could be good, but they might not be perfect for you. So I really do recommend that you guys set up a time with any sort of Notion consultant. Doesn't have to be me. I obviously have a link. You can sign up to a discovery call with me to figure out what you want to get out of your stuff. And if you're a business or somebody who has the financial means to get some consulting done, more than happy to make the time for you. And if you want to learn how to improve your productivity even more, check out this video right here.